Hello, everybody. We're going to go over some kind of advanced sourcing tips to help you find more candidates. So one of the common tactics used by expert sourcers or senior sourcers is to take a keyword. Let's take job title, for instance. If you're sourcing for a back-end engineer, a lot of sources and recruiters, believe it or not, will just put in back-end engineer in LinkedIn and whatever tools they're using in their ATS. And then they'll put in some keywords, hopefully. And you'll get X amount of candidates, right? But by adding more keywords, synonyms, or alternative keywords, you will double, triple, quadruple the amount of candidates that you find, because not everyone has that exact job title. So we're gonna jump in to ChatGPT and we're going to ask ChatGPT to help us. Let's jump right in. Okay, so I'm in ChatGPT and I'm gonna keep going with the same example of back-end engineers, right? So I'm gonna cut and paste a prompt to save us some time. This is an advanced mega prompt. And I'm gonna hit go. I'll show you the prompt here in a second and we'll break it down. So right now as ChatGPT is thinking, we've been given one word, back-end engineer. And we wanna get a list of synonyms, right? And then we're gonna turn it into a search string and then we're gonna find more candidates. It's that simple. Now, right now there are 30 keywords that are similar to back-end engineer, okay? And then here's a prompt that I'm using. You can see here, that's the prompt. And then those are the keywords that I'm using. Okay, so now what do we do with these words, right? We're gonna get these keywords. You can cut and paste them into, if you use a tool or an Excel spreadsheet, to combine them, or let's ask ChatGPT to help us. I'm gonna say, so all I've asked it is to create a Boolean search string with all these keywords. And there we go. In this case, since I didn't tell it what the output format was, it puts it in code, but that's not a big deal because we can just copy and paste it over. So you'll see it's still building it. All those keywords are there. So all I have to do is copy that code and put it into whatever tool you're using. And it's just that simple. With this one idea, a lot of sourcers and recruiters will be just searching for that, and you're gonna come up with a whole bunch of candidates that people haven't found. Now imagine if you did this for all of your keywords and then grouped them all together. Now this is not a sourcing class, but let me jump into something that was taught in a different class just to kind of give you an idea. Okay, so I promised that I would break down this prompt for you. So I've cut and pasted into a little bit of a cleaner background so you can get an idea. So right here, you'll see that I've put it in a role or a persona that we covered in building mega prompts, right? And then we've started to give it a task. We're gonna tell it what it's doing. But now some advanced prompt engineering tips is to really give it some instructions on how to complete this task, okay? So in the beginning, maybe we would say, okay, do a role and then give it a task, right? But you'll see here that we've given it a lot more to do. So if you look at 5, 6, and 7, that's really changed the game. So you'll see here, this one is basic, that's basic, but all of these here have really taken it to another step, right? And that's how we got those amazing results, okay? Okay, now I said that this wasn't a sourcing class, but I do wanna show you what I was talking about. In the Boolean masterclass on how to create consistent, powerful search strings, I will show you how to do this. And basically what I'd like you to do is to concentrate on only the blue, okay? Now, what I've done is the words that are stacked going up and down, you'll see that, you'll see here, you'll see right here that I've said those are or statements, right? And then the ones that are here are gonna be and statements, okay? It can be confusing for a lot of recruiters who don't know Boolean search string, but it's real simple. If you stack one word, those are synonyms, right? So if we go to here, and let's say these are the keywords, we found five job titles, right? So in this, I said job titles. So I've got five different job titles that all mean the same thing, right? Just like we did. And I put an or in between them. So that way you're telling your ATS, search engines, whatever tools you're saying, find me a backend engineer or a system engineer or an API developer or, so that's how you put all those synonyms into one powerful group, right? And then you could go on to put the keywords in. So then whatever those requirements are, I break down every requirement into a group. And then you combine them all together and you get this massive search string. But the reason I teach this is because a lot of people just put in backend engineer, Python, distributed technology, and then they find people. I mean, you can put a bunch of words together and find people, but then when your manager comes back and says, okay, we don't need Python, or we don't need anything with object-oriented, whatever it may be, you're not gonna know how to uncouple or untangle that keyword. So by stacking them, if your manager says, no, we don't need this, we can just take that out of your search string without affecting the whole thing. So that's just a real, an advanced tip on how to do this. And I'd love for you to take this particular course. So in this lesson, we've asked ChatGPT to give us a bunch of alternatives and we got 30 of them. So I hope that makes sense. I'm curious to see what you think.